This is a lionfish, a beautiful looking species that come from the warm waters of the Indo-Pacific region near the South Pacific Ocean. It is known for its distinct red and white stripes and its long venomous spines that serve for a variety of purposes. But don't worry, although a sting from these spines can be painful to humans, it is rarely fatal. Now if you've heard anything about a lionfish, you've either heard that it makes really good food or that it's an invasive species, and that it's made its way all the way to the North Atlantic, more specifically, the Caribbean. But how does a fish get all the way from the South Pacific to the North Atlantic? In the early 2000s, lionfish began to show up in Florida. At the time, it wasn't an issue for the reef, and in fact, the fish was at high value to aquariums and museums. Fish don't swim across oceans alone though, so the only way the species could get from one side of the planet to the other would be through human activity. Although nobody knows how lionfish truly got to Florida, there are two main theories that attempt to explain this issue. Theory number one, aquariums, the most popular theory. During the 90s, home aquariums were a very popular thing. Enthusiasts typically traveled across the world to capture certain types of fish, and many speculated that lionfish were one of those species wanted by those people. Either the fish became too big and they had to release them, or Hurricane Andrew in 1992 accidentally released the fish into Florida waters. Theory number two, ballast water. One of the main ways invasive species are introduced into the new environment is through ballast water in cargo ships. When these ships deliver their cargo, there's nothing to weigh the ship down on the trip back, so these ships have to fill these tanks with water to provide stability. It's rare, but sometimes the filling of these tanks cause nearby fish to get sucked in. Then the ship travels to its next destination and lets out the water along with those fish. The release of ballast water has introduced several non-native species to new areas several times, including the green crab, killer algae, and the zebra mussel, which are all currently invasive to their new environments. Regardless of how the lionfish arrived here, they are now a heavily invasive species. Becoming sexually mature in less than a year, these fish are able to reproduce fast and stay alive for at least 10 years. Before I talk about how lionfish affect the reef though, let's take a look at the lionfish anatomy. Alright, maybe a little bit too dramatic, but let's take a look at this fish and all the spines that surround it. At the top, you can see the venomous dorsal spines. Behind them, the posterior dorsal fins, which have spines but aren't venomous. At the tail, we also have a non-venomous caudal fin, venomous back spines below the tail, and pelvic fins, which are also venomous. Although it may seem like these spines can be used to attack, the lionfish uses it purely for defense against predators. They also allow the fish to stick to rough surfaces easier, and are sometimes used as an intimidation tactic for its prey. But back to how the lionfish affect the reef. Feeding on snappers, groupers, parrotfish, and shrimp, the lionfish eats many different types of sea animals. Not only does it affect native fish, but it also affects the reef itself. You see, coral reefs work together with the entire environment to survive. Coral can't survive on its own without fish, and vice versa. When fish are eaten, take for example, herbivores, those type of fish eat algae. Without this fish around, algae grows without limit, causing damage to the reef's health. Since lionfish eat many different types of sea organisms, this can affect many different parts of the ecosystem. Just to put this into perspective, an individual female lionfish lays 2 million eggs each year. 2 million. Although many do not survive maturity, this is still a very large number of eggs being laid, every single year. Since lionfish have no natural predators, they're able to spread fast through this environment. Fish do eat lionfish, however. These include sharks, groupers, and eels. More and more possible predators of the lionfish are learning how to eat this species. And this brings me to my next point. How are humans dealing with this issue? Here are the three main ways to deal with this invasive species. The first is spearfishing. The second, traps. And third, eating. Of course, spearfishing is pretty self-explanatory, but there are multiple ways to do this. One of the easiest ways and the most used forms of spearfishing is through using a sling spear, which is essentially a catapult attached to your hand. This is the same spear I used to spearfish lionfish in Roatan, an island off the coast of Honduras in the Caribbean. You can also use a spear gun, which is a tethered harpoon-like device that kills with controlled force. Regardless of how you kill the lionfish, doing it is what's important. One of the most recently developed forms of dealing with this issue now are traps. New ones are being developed each year, and they are getting better and better at trapping lionfish. Organizations like NOAA or NOAA and other nonprofit organizations work on developing different types of traps to deal with this even more effectively. Lastly, eating lionfish is what everyone can do to help reduce the spread of this lionfish. While we will never be able to get rid of them, ordering lionfish at a restaurant that serves it helps support the regular fishing of this invasive species. Lionfish can be made into sushi, ceviche, soup, and more, not to mention it is very good. As we're nearing the end of this video, I hope you have learned something about this invasive species and how it affects the reef. I hope you are now motivated to do something about this issue, and maybe are excited to try it as a food. Please, educate others about this as well as you can, to help stop the spread as fast as possible. The more people know about this problem, the better. I also hope you enjoyed my short video. I created this for my 10th grade bio class. Thanks for watching, and do your part to save the reef.